Greetings of the day. I am Lakshman Jajodia, Assistant Professor, Department of Advanced Management Studies, GS College of Commerce, Wardha. In the last video of Project Appraisal and Finance, we have discussed about the sensitivity analysis method for risk analysis in capital budgeting. We have taken one numerical in that particular video. Now we will start with another question or another problem in the similar pattern so that we could have better understanding of the question. The question says that Well-Being Limited has again two exclusive projects, Project A and Project B. Each requires an initial cash outlay of rupees 8 lakh. Both the project has an economic life of 15 years, over which the estimated cash flows are given in the three assumptions which we have discussed in the sensitivity analysis. The first assumption was a pessimistic approach, that is the worst situation in which project A would generate at least 1,20,000 of cash inflow, whereas project B would not have any kind of cash inflows. In the most likely or expected situation, we are going to have a cash inflow of 1,60,000 for project A and project B as well. In the optimistic or best situation, we are going to have cash inflow of 2,20,000 and 3,40,000. In this particular problem, it has been said that we have cost of capital of 10%. We have to advise which project is more risky. So PBR for 15 years, that is the economic life of project, at the rate 10% is 7.606, which has been already provided in the question. We will start with the solution formulation. Again, the parameter would be simple. We have to calculate NPV in this situation also. We have three possible outcomes or three possible situations: pessimistic, most likely, and optimistic. We have taken all the three situations. Cash flows for project A, as we have discussed in the last video, we have to divide the table into two parts, one for project A and one for project B. In project A, we have four parts, subdivision. First for cash inflow, second for discounting factor, third for present value, and fourth for net present value, and likewise for project B also. Cash inflows, which are already mentioned in the problem, for project A 1,20,000, for pessimistic approach, for most likely it is 1,60,000, and for optimistic approach it was 2,20,000. PBR already provided in the question, 7.606 for 15 years cumulative. We have taken direct cumulative value because, as mentioned earlier in the earlier video, cash inflows are equal for all 15 years. That is why we have taken cumulative value. If cash inflows are unstructured, fragmented, different, we would have to take PVF, that is present value factor, different for each value. So 7.606, again we will use same method for calculating the present value. 1,20,000 into 7.606, that is our PVIF, is equals to our present value of 9,12,720 for pessimistic situation. For most likely situation, 1,60,000 into 7.606 is equals to 12,16,960, that is our present value. For optimistic, 2,20,000, that is our cash inflow, multiplied by 7.606 is equals to 16,73,320. This is our present value. But we need to calculate net present value. Whenever we have to calculate net present value, we have to deduct our investment from the present value. For this particular question, our investment was of rupees 8 lakh. That is why 9,12,720 minus 8 lakh equals to 1,12,720. That is our NPV. Similarly, 12,16,960 minus 8 lakh equals to 4,16,960. Lastly, for optimistic approach, 16,73,320 minus 8 lakh equals to 8,73,320 for project A. What we have seen, we have positive net present value for all three situations in project A. Now we will take project B into consideration. Again, cash flow for pessimistic approach is 0, nil. We have not taken it. For most likely or expected situation, we have 1,60,000. And for optimistic, it is 3,40,000. Present value factor already given in cumulative nature. We have taken the same. As we don't have the cash inflow for pessimistic approach, our answer is nil, 0. Secondly, for most likely we have cash inflow of 160,000 multiplied by present value factor 7.606 equals to 1,16,916. For lastly, 3,40,000 was our cash inflow multiplied by cumulative present value factor 7.606 equals to 25,86,040. And now we can compute our net present value. As the cost of project B was also 8 lakh, we have to deduct 8 lakh from present value, which we have calculated in rupees. So in the first situation, as we don't have any kind of present value, in the pessimistic approach, we could have negative NPV of the investment, that is 8 lakh. In the second situation, we have present value of 18,16,960 minus 8 lakh equals to 4,16,960. In the optimistic approach, we have our present value of 25,86,040 minus 8 lakh equals to 17,86,040. The question has asked us to advise to the company which project is more risky. Definitely we can see that the NPV of project A is positive, whereas NPV of project B for one situation is negative, and for second situation, third situation, it is positive. But since in one situation it is negative, which can be a possibility if we take the project, we will classify project B as a risky project, which a company should not opt according to the conservative approach, because we can see this is the best possible outcome if we accept project in either of the three situations we are in positive NPV, whether in this situation we are in negative NPV. Even though if we go for some minute analysis, we see that in pessimistic approach, definitely project B should be discarded as it is giving negative return. In most likely approach, both the projects have same returns. Only in the optimistic approach, there is a almost more than twice difference between both the projects. That is why if a manager is risk taking, definitely he or she will go for project B. But according to the conservative approach and risk analysis, the company should avoid project B because it is more risky, which was advisable to the company that project B is more riskier than project A. Keep watching our YouTube channel. Until then, stay tuned. Thank you.